Hi, this is Shivakumar, UI trainer and NourishEye Technologies. And today we are going to discussing the differences between block level helmets and inline helmets. What is the difference between block level helmet, inline helmet? So some of the helmets in our HTML block level and some of the helmets are inline helmets. So by default, they comes with some block level nature and some are comes with the inline nature. So what is the difference between these two? Either we have the data presentation or the functioning. So that we are going to discussing now. Now see, every block level helmet, they occupies the full line horizontally. Each and every block level, example H1 tag, H2 tag, all heading tags, as well as the paragraph tag, as well as the division tag, whatever it may be, how many block level elements we have in our HTML, those all are, what is the length as well as the width of the block level? The full line, exact measurement we don't have, container width it will takes. The length of the block level tag as well as the width of the block level tag is equivalent to your container width. If you don't have any special container, generally it will takes the body width. So suppose this white color area is our body, our web page body. Right? But what is the width of H1 tag, sir? Almost the same width. So our body, how much width available? H1 tag is also occupies the almost the same width. So this is our H1 tag. Observe the box, sir. That is the area of the H1. Observe the box here, that is the area of the H1. So height decided based on the number of lines. The width come length, it decided based on the container width. Container 1000 pixels available. Your H1 tag also 1000 pixels are available. Container 500 pixels available. Generally H1 tag, not only H1, every block level. Here I am showing example with H1. So container, how much width available, then the block level tag also occupies the same width. So container is 1000 pixels, sir. Block level tag also by default 1000 pixels it will come. Container 500 pixels available, block level tag also generally it occupies the 500 pixels. Can you control this size? Yes, by using some CSS properties we can manage the length. We can control the width. I'm here just explaining the default size. We are not writing any CSS. The default size of the every block level tag is the width of the container. Then what about the inline? Inline tag generally it occupies the length or width based on the content. This is. How much data we have, as per the data length, the length of the tag is also going to occupy. The tag is occupies how much space? Depends on the content length. So suppose we typed here 10 alphabets I typed. But what is the length of the tag, sir? And 10 alphabets equivalent to size. So who is this, sir? Suppose it is a span tag. So span is one of the inline tag. H1 is one of the block level tag. Block level element and inline element, right? So width of the H1 as well as the block level, the whole line, and width of these inline elements depends upon the content length. If I want to organize or if you want to customize this for H1 tag or the span tag, length or height, if you want to customize any of that, generally we have to use CSS. So this is the default length of the block level and inline. One major difference, this one, size. Second difference, every block level tag, it displaying always a line by line. Generally. So this is another block level element, H2. Separate line it will comes. I have one paragraph also here. I have one paragraph. Paragraph is also block level. So it also occupies same the container width, and the data is goes to like this. The data is goes to like this. So what is this tags? This is paragraph. It is paragraph. H1, H2, paragraph. Three elements as well as three tags. And the three tags are always displaying in the separate line or in the fresh line. The general nature, default nature. But we observe sometimes if they are displaying the side by side, sir. Side by side they are displaying, and conformally we implemented CSS. Without implementing the CSS generally, or without writing any special code, they never comes to side by side. Without writing any special code, they never comes to side by side. This is the nature, another difference. Comes to the span tags, what happens? Now the span tag is takes always the side by side. In generally, or by default, span tag is always displaying the side by side. Where the first tag, first element is ended, their next position, second element is comes. Second position ending, third element is going to start. The previous element ending position, it takes as a next element starting position. So this is the span tag. Who is this, sir? Suppose anchor tag. Suppose it is an anchor tag. I have one more span tag, suppose. This is another span tag. So who is this, sir? It is also image tag. Span tag. Span, anchor, image. All these are the inline elements. And all are displaying always the side by side. In general nature, they are displaying always side by side. But when it comes to the block level tag, they are displaying always in the separate line or in the fresh line. The second difference. Second difference is this one. And third difference is event handling related. If you implement any event handling on block level tag as well as the inline tag, the impacted area is also different. Suppose if I developed event handling, or if I implemented event handling, what is the event, sir? On click. On click I implemented on H1. On click I implemented on H1. What is the impact? Not only on the data set, total black color box. This total black color box, if you click anywhere, the event is going to triggering. Not only on the data. Data after we have some empty space also, some gap available. In that gap, if you click it, then the event is going to triggering. All block level tags like that only. H2 tag after, we have a lot of gap here. So if I click on this gap, sir, event is going to triggering. Every block level tag like that only. But while it comes to the inline elements, inside this blue box only your event is going to trigger. Inside the blue box, or inside the red color box, or inside the block color box, within the block, within the red, within the blue color, there only the event is triggering. Suppose I implemented on click event. Same event. Where, sir? On image tag, on image element. What happens, sir? Image, how much area occupied? Image, how much area occupied? That much of area only event is applying. These empty areas, event not applying anything. That empty areas, event not applying anything. So the content, how much area is there? Event impacted to that area only. Empty space after the tag, before the tag, it's never going to activating the event. But block level tags, event data not available, but the space is occupied. Space occupied already up to end of the line. Up to end of the line, anywhere event is going to triggering. On the data or after the data also. But in that single line, in that single line. These are the major differences between the block level elements and inline elements. Thank you all.